What's going on, guys? Drake here. Welcome to another reaction video on a Sunday. You guys really enjoyed these, and there must have been about 200-300 comments. Yes, I read every comment, although I don't get the time to reply to thousands of comments. There's a lot of people who want me to react to Rangers, so throughout the week I've watched a lot of stuff in regards to U.S. Army Rangers. I'm really impressed in what I'm seeing, really enjoy watching the content, got a little bit more of an insight. However, there's a few things I don't really understand. If you could help me out and leave it in the comment section, because I can't find anything online. How do you become a Ranger? How do you even apply for it? Do you have to go first to basic and get picked to go to the Ranger school or so? I don't know, and I can't seem to find the right information online. If you're new to the channel, guys, feel free to subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. It helps my little channel out. Also, I'm a serving soldier in the British Army. I'm going to do these reaction videos every Sunday in regards to every branch in every country, just to look at the differences between the British Army and the rest of the world. Enjoy this reaction. Right, let's get this reaction started. That looks like a bag of fun. Bloody hell. I don't know what's going on here, guys. Obviously they seem to be going through some intense training at the minute. I don't know if this basic training or how it works. Like I said at the beginning of the video, guys, I'd really appreciate if you let me know what's going on and put it in the comment section. To me, this looks just like a thrashing. Obviously, is it the toughest combat course in the world? A lot of people claim it to be. I can't comment on that, obviously, because I haven't done it myself, so I can't really comment on that. However, from what I've seen it so far, it is really intense. And as I mentioned already earlier, throughout the week I watched a lot of footage, and a lot of it was stuff I've never done in the British Army, and never, you know, come across anyone who's actually done it. So they are definitely a little bit above the rest, if that makes sense. Carry on with this video.
Yeah.
Right. What's the purpose of them constantly getting sprayed down while doing the exercises? Is it because it's too hot, or is that just a normal thing? Please leave in the comment section and let me know why they're constantly getting sprayed with water. Something I've never seen. Again, like I said earlier on, it seems really tough. I really don't know what's going on. But I can just imagine that it's just sheer determination that gets him through that type of training. Do I think a normal civilian can just jump in and do that? Obviously not. But if you train for it, I'm sure if you put your mind to it and train for something, you can achieve it. And, you know, regardless of how tough it is, you know, you definitely can achieve it. It's not something, you know, obviously our flashings are completely different. The obstacle courses are completely different. We've got different tests. Every branch has got their own little different tests, their requirements. Obviously in the British Army, I hold my hands up, the best military, as in like the best British Army course to do, and the toughest one is obviously the parachute regiment, which the course is called P Company. That is probably the pinnacle of the normal British Army. Whereas for you guys in the US Army, I'm guessing it's the Rangers that are the pinnacle of the whole of the US Army branch. But that's just my guess. As I said, I don't really know what's going on. Guys, how much do you carry on that 12 miler in the US Rangers? Is it 35 pounds or 40 pounds or something? Or is it even more? But yeah, leave it in the comment section and let me know how much you carry. Is this for time? Do you actually have to do it in a certain time, or how does it work? So what's next? Prepare for airborne jump. Gosh, Rangers are really trained up in everything, aren't they? Abseiling, airborne, bloody everything. Everything I watch from the Rangers, they just about do everything. Yeah. I think I'm going to advance this a little bit. Patrol's an ambush. I'm guessing they're navigating. Why the hell? Right, why is she shouting? Is this non-tactical? Or what's going on? Why is she shouting? Obviously you're gonna give your position away if it's march and ambush or whatever you're doing there. It seems a bit senseless to me. Guessing that section attacks. I love that, it's pretty cool. Right. I don't know what it is, but it really bugs me that they're just shouting. It makes absolutely no sense if you're attacking something or if you're pulling out. Why would you shout and give your position away? Please leave it in the comment section. It's bugging me. I don't know why. But yeah, let's finish it off here. Right guys, I hope you really enjoyed this little reaction video. I mean, I couldn't comment on too many things. But as I already mentioned, throughout the entire week, I've watched a lot of Rangers footage. And I must say they are definitely a cut above the rest when it comes to normal military units, that type of stuff. Please leave it in the comment sections in regards to all the questions I've had. I'd really appreciate it, and I'm sure a lot of other people across Europe and that would appreciate reading those comments. If you've got any experience in the Rangers and that, please leave it in the comment sections. I've never really looked into the Rangers until the last week. I have heard a lot of good stuff about them in regards to the Second World War and stuff like that, and it's really interesting. Guys, if you really enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already. I'd really appreciate it, and let's see what I'm going to react to next week. Take care.